Only a month till Christmas. Ooh. And lockdown 2.0 has ended too, so all things to celebrate. I hope you'll stay with me for the next half hour as we chat about all things yarn and fabric. Here's what's coming up. Hello, welcome back. Good to see you all again as we do another season 2 dark mode vlog. I'm nice and cozy here in the potting shed and I'm sporting another knit. I told you, I thought, what shall it be? Shall it be a Josh Bennett one? Or which Josh Bennett one shall it be? Well, I went for the hoodie. This is the Josh Bennett hoodie. Lovely knit and so clever, purely because it's done with the three yarns. You will change the colours of those three yarns as the knit goes on. So say for example, at one point you've got two browns and a red. As those three yarns go around the needle, of course you get different parts of the yarn showing through. So you might get more red one time, or you might get more brown. And because it's three yarns, oh, it's so chunky and squishy and cosy. And look at the I-cord finishing off, but it is just wonderful. Look at the hood. It's keeping me wonderfully warm here in the potting shed as it does get much, much colder now. Speaking of knits, it's finished and it's finally time to premiere it. Let's show you the Harry Styles cardigan. I have to say, I'm amazed at it. I love it. Absolutely love it. I didn't think I was going to. And that's partly because when I was wearing Collins, it was lovely, but it was just so big. And I think because it was done with real wool as well, you know what real wool is like on a big coat type of garment? It can pull and stretch. Whereas this is with acrylic, and of course, I didn't actually end up sewing all the panels together. The pattern is made up of panels, and there are four sections to a panel, four sections high. And those panels then are made up into the jumper. Six across the back, six across the front. Well, three on the left front, three on the right front. But as you saw with Colin's version, it was wonderfully big. It is what they call a uni size or a one size fits all. But I did want something a bit more fitting. So I thought, well, rather than having the whole six across the back, I'll take one off each end. So I only had four, and the same with the front. Took one off the front left and one off the front right. So I had two and two. So you can see here now, I've got my two panels, which make my four front, and I've got four on the back. So it then makes it a lot more fitting, a lot more snug. It's like, what could you say? It's like a bomber jacket. I love it. The same is done with the sleeves. The sleeves are here, but rather than having four, which means you'd have two on the front and two on the back. But I thought, no, let's just sew two up. And it makes for a wonderfully snug sleeve. And that bomber jacket feel. The collar is still the same. The button band is still the same. And
obviously the rib is just a bit shorter, but can you see that lovely crochet detail as well?
Did everything else as per pattern with the whole of sewing it up and putting the cuffs on and leaving these bits here, which are design features as stated in the pattern. So everything else was done per pattern other than just sewing four up rather than six. And I love it, really wearable, really pleased. And pleased to say as well, we've got the kits available. Yep, finally got the yarn in, because a lot of the yarn companies here in the UK have been overwhelmed during lockdown, which is wonderful. A bit frustrating for me as a yarn shop, and certainly fabric as well, because a lot of the yarn is either at the warehouse or not being made because of social distancing and everything, or the fabric is actually stuck in containers on boats because they just can't get it here in time. But finally got it. Here is the kit. You can buy the Harry Styles cardigan, as you see me wearing, as a kit. And it all comes to £60. It was quite a fair bit of wool, actually. It's about, I think there's about 19 balls of wool, and then 3 balls for your Aran weight to make the cuffs. But it is a great knit. It's enough wool there to make all the panels. So if you wanted 6 on the back and 6 on the front, and the baggy sleeves with 4 and 4 and 4, there is enough there. If you want to do my version, obviously you won't sew up all the panels, but you can do something with those leftover panels.
Yeah. Reusing everything up,
you can make
pockets.
How cool is that? Pockets. We all love a pocket, don't we? So I'm really, really pleased. So I used the leftover panels up and I just sewed it all in and knocked up a pocket. So it's so good use of all the yarn, but it's great. Really, really pleased. If you go onto YouTube or even onto Instagram and type in Harry Styles cardigan, you will see so many people making their own versions. So I'm really, really pleased with it. And he's starting to cause a bit of a stir at the moment as well over in America, being on the Vogue magazine and dressed in all sort of, well, a mixture of clothing, and to see him on Vogue as well. So very in at the moment. But there we go. Harry Styles cardigan. I'm really, really pleased with it. One thing that I have been able to do during lockdown 2.0 here in the UK is to go out for a walk, and for many walks, but one in particular walk is a walk that I have sponsored in Long Melford. And there was this idea to put together some walks in and around Long Melford and to make these nice sort of maps that shows you the walk and explains different points of interest on it. And I thought, I'd love to be involved with that. I love walking myself. So I sponsored one of the walks and had my name put to it. And I decided to go on that very walk and film it. So take a look at this. Already, and I have got the map. It's only a short walk. It's 1.5 miles, but it goes around the back of the shop, our own little walk. It goes around the back of the shop to the watermelon. So let's go and take a look and see what it's like, because I've never been there. So we've got to point of interest one on the map, a crinkle crankle wall. The crinkle crankle wall economises on bricks despite its sinuous configuration, because it can be made just one brick thin. Suffolk has more of these types of walls than anywhere else in England. Fabulous, wonderfully wavy, and so smooth. So this is Chad Brook, lovely little part on the walk. You can often see a kingfisher or an otter or two if you're lucky. Sometimes we forget to look backwards when we walk, and I just stopped and turned around and had a look backwards, and look at that. Holy Trinity Church. You can see the tower in the background. A wool church based on the monies that was coming in the wool trade in the 15th century. So we've just come out the Kissing Gate and had a look at the old plate layer's hut, and look at that, sun's come out. So we're now going to carry on straight across the water meadows. So just arrived at, what is it, point of interest 5, the last one on the walk, and you should be able to see in the background that field undulating everywhere. Apparently it's the site of, the remains of a Roman villa. Right, Jen lives not far from the walk, so let's sneak up on her, shall we? I had a good catch up with Jen. Jen helps me out at the shop, as you know. You would have seen her before, and she comes and helps me on a Monday to clear up. And of course, I haven't seen her for ages because of lockdown, so that's nice to talk through the window. Oh, look what I've found. A curly wall. Look. Now it's the home straight, just back on Hall Street, walking back to the shop. We've done so much, it's been bang, 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 and then what with that walk as well, I think it's time that we relax the pace. You know what's coming up. Yes, we love this little moment where everything just chills a bit and slows down. So kick off your walking boots, get that drink, get that cuppa, get that hot chocolate, as we take a couple minutes out to take a look at the stunning work that you've been making over the last couple of weeks. Here's the gallery. some stunning work again, as always, in the gallery. I keep saying this every time, but it is just a wonderful moment to be inspired by and to get the creative juices flowing. If you're deciding on what to do next as your, you know, next project, then the gallery is great for inspiring that. But what I also love is seeing the vast array of things you're making. It's not just knitting and crochet or patchwork. There's all sorts going on there. So lovely to see. Keep them coming in. You know what to do. You can email them to me at info@thewoolpatch.com, or you can just hashtag us, hashtag the wool patch, and that will trigger it my end so I can see what you've done, and then I can compile it ready for the next gallery. As we say, we love seeing your work. Now, I follow Zach Stout on YouTube. He has a podcast vlog like I do, well, like many of us do. And it was actually last Friday I saw one, because it was a new one from Zach. He's upping his output, and he's doing basically one every Friday. And last Friday, his new podcast is a free pattern Friday. And just talking about inspiration, where you get inspired from. And he showed a pattern on there from a designer who's based in the Netherlands, a Polish designer called Renata, for a crochet snowflake. Just look at that. It is phenomenal. So I've literally just finished this. I did this in a couple of hours. It doesn't take long at all. Now, what I liked about this pattern is, which is why I was inspired by it, so thank you, Zach, for introducing me to this new designer, is that it used a crochet technique that I'd never done before. Behind the post or in front of the post, and I had no clue. Now I know what it is. It's like, oh, that's so easy. And I will try and show you on here. Crochet, we are used to going under the two V's, aren't we, across the top. That's the way most people crochet. The general double crochet, treble crochet, so forth. You go through under the two V's and you pull up a loop and you do the stitch. And of course, stitches differ in height. Double, treble, double, treble, triple, treble. And the more you do, the longer the stitch. And the long bit of the stitch, of the crochet stitch, is what they call the post. That's a post. That's a post. That's a post. And what it does is it gives you this fabulous rib effect, especially through the back post, because it pushes those V's that you used to go under to the front. So you get this wonderful ridge effect. And then this is my favourite. From going through the front post, you then get this ridge on the front and it puts the rest into relief. It just looks fractal, like a snowflake, which is made up of all those segments. And isn't it just... Wonderful. So thank you, Zach, for you don't know who Zach is, type it into YouTube, have a search. He is a crocheter, massively brilliant crocheter. So he talks about crochet all the time. So I'm going to be making loads of those to go round the house and in here in a couple of weeks' time when we have our Christmas episode. Oh, I can't wait. We can have it all Christmassy because we're putting the decorations up soon. I know you in America have just had Thanksgiving and you've got the Christmas decorations up already. Oh, love it. Love everything about Christmas. Really, really good. So, what else to talk to you about? Ah, new fabric that's just come into the shop from my, I think now they are my favourite fabric make or fabric brand, Dear Stella. Take a look at this. Rock. It's great, isn't it? Oh, I love it. So there's the Jurassic Forest that you saw. There's the title, You Rock. Oh, and then the mini dinos, like on a buttery yellow. It's just wonderful. And just when I saw it, I thought I've just got to have it. Hey, so there would have been four in the collection, and that's really manageable for me as a small shop. A little bit of a collection and one colourway. There are other brands like Moda where you get one collection and it comes in three different colourways with about 10 prints in each colourway. And you just think, oh, choices. And sometimes when you're overwhelmed with a choice, you actually end up don't making a choice at all because you can't decide. Whereas that, when I saw those three, I just went, yeah, got to have them. So it was really, really good. But the designs are nice. And then, of course, we've got a country mouse, which is just, well, for a country boy, just had to be done. So that one, Town and Country, which you saw, Woodland Frolic. And then the portrait gallery with all their faces. So when you see that as a collection, it's just beautiful. And that's done on really dark teals with a light blossom and almost a navy, very autumnal feel. And that was four in the collection, but bolt number four is on back order, sadly, which is gutting, because when you get a new collection in the shop, you want to have it all at once, because what happens if those three sell really quickly, and then 2 months later, in it comes. So I'm hoping the fourth one will come very soon. To make up a beautiful collection. But what also is nice about that is, and the same with the UROC one, it's just a different colour palette. It's not being too stereotypical of boy and girl, of gender, which I often see in the fabric world. And it's very difficult with certain companies that, well, I suppose they have their certain colours and they know what sells, but they tend to chuck out the same colours. And so what I liked about that is it was just different. It's sort of kind of, they say gender neutral, don't they? Where it doesn't typify anything, so. Wow, that's half an hour gone already. The show whizzes by. Hope you've enjoyed it. I've loved having your company. If you can spread the word, if you haven't already subscribed, I'd love you to click that button. I'm hoping that the more and more subscribers we get, the more and more this YouTube channel can help support the shop and then help, in turn, the shop grow even more. So it's been lovely to have your company. Thanks for subscribing and watching, and see you next time.